if you hear autonomous boat and you don't have a lot of experience in it, it sounds kind of like a robot. But it thinks, it does maneuvers that you would do yourself.
It's not science fiction. It looks like it sometimes, but this is here. This technology is here now.
And it can perceive things that humans can't. Autonomy doesn't get tired. It's ready to be shown to the world. It's exciting times.
We do a lot of our testing in Boston Harbor. Generally, people are pretty curious for obvious reasons. I mean, it's a big yellow boat that says autonomous vessel on it. The commercial vessels know who we are, and we're all very respectful of each other, and it's actually an excellent place to work and a really great place for us to test, so we're really lucky.
I love this weather. It still blows my mind that I get paid to do this shit.
I'm Chris Hotzing. I'm the Director of Engineering at Sea Machines. I look after a team of hardware and software engineers to deliver the next generation of autonomy to the maritime market. Boats have a bigger impact on your life than you probably appreciate. Everything from shipping to harbor protection, transportation, ferries, all these industries have an effect on most people more than they probably realize. I think something like 90% of goods are moved across the world in vessels. As trade grows and more goods are being moved and more vessels are being used to do that, there are lots of opportunities to make that more efficient and predictable. And that's where technology can really help. It can optimize routes for these vessels. It can share information between them. It can increase these vessels' ability to detect each other and other static objects even to make sure that collisions are avoided.
This is Steadfast, our unmanned surface vessel. Some people have even called it a robot boat. We just refer to it as an autonomous vessel. I think autonomy is going to be transforming most industries going forward, and the maritime industry is no different.
An autonomous watercraft is much like an autonomous car in that it can operate all by itself without a human in the loop. The sensors that we're using on the autonomous system are used on most boats already. Radar and AIS, GPS, these are already installed. Our system can be easily retrofit to new boats, old boats, a 20-foot survey vessel, or a 60-foot tug in all the same way. It's using the same box with the same general inputs. I think it surprises folks to find out that autonomous vessels are actually here now.
This technology is not science fiction. Looks like it sometimes, but it's actually ready to go.
I was a cadet on a 1,000-foot car carrier that went to the Middle East and back. If you asked me 5-10 years ago if I'd be working on an autonomous boat, I would absolutely have said no. I thought it was way more in the theory stages than it is in the production stages. So that was kind of a shock, a very positive shock, but definitely surprised me.
Yeah, we're going to be heading off of Marblehead and demonstrating some of our autonomous technology. That's going to include some waypoints, some surveys, we'll do some collision avoidance tests, and then some formation sailing.
The mission we're about to do is a collision avoidance mission. So essentially, we'll be in full autonomy and we will go from point A to point B. I just dropped two waypoints and it's a straight line, so Hopper is going to come in and basically try to hit us. We try to do it straight away just so the hopper can easily predict where we're gonna be. With this system, you're able to create a bunch of missions. You could do it at the dock, you could just do it at your desk. The boat will be fully autonomous as soon as I click these buttons.
Okay, stand by, here we go.
The boat's fully autonomous right now, as you can see. The hopper is coming in now, so they're gonna try to hit us.
You feel us adjusting? So we're actually taking its speed and its heading into account. You can feel us slowing down, waiting for it to go by. As it goes by, you'll feel the speed pick up again, and we'll continue on. So the system is taking in the position of that vessel. It's detected it. It's detected its speed and its heading. It's going to factor that into the decision-making algorithm.
I love that. I love when it kind of turns like that to kind of avoid, like turning at the boat, but avoiding it. It's like one of my favorite parts. Because we don't tell it to do that. We don't say, turn right. It just calculates, like, what's the best place I should possibly position myself in. It's just what I would do if I were driving. Tell me that's not cool. I will never get tired of that.
Applying collision avoidance is, I mean, it's something that mariners do every day. They take into account the radar and the AIS, just like the boat's doing. It's just like one less thing that's completely in the hands of the navigator. I don't think it's meant to be a replacement of anybody. I think it's more supplemental than anything. It's just, it's increasing the safety, and that's all there is to it. The maritime industry is very slow to change. I don't think that there's anyone afraid of actual autonomy, but just change. I think that a lot of industries kind of push back on change sometimes, but it really is the logical next step. It's already in cars, it's in farming, it's in so many things already that it's just getting over that bridge that it's still really new. But once that happens, I don't think that anyone is gonna think that it's negatively impacting anything.
All right, Hopper, go ahead. We're ready whenever you are.
All right, we're underway.
So we've specified an offset to the mothership, Hopper, in this case. This is a fully autonomous behavior, but where we go is really up to where the mothership goes. We'll just follow at that offset. So right now they're making a turn to port. So our offset position is going to be moving with that, and we're going to be following it around. You'll feel it speed up a little bit as it makes that turn, but we're always going to be trying to keep the vessel exactly in that position specified by the offset.
This could be applicable to like an oil spill response. So you would have one mothership boat and then an autonomous boat. They could stay the same distance off each other and they could drag an oil boom and clean up the spill. You wouldn't need to stop as much, you wouldn't need to switch crews, and it would be a lot more efficient and productive. I think it's gonna be a huge game changer.
AI can optimize efficiency in a vessel by taking in all sorts of information from the environment, current, wind, weather forecasts in the future, and optimize that vessel's path to ensure the minimal amount of energy is being used to get the vessel from point A to point B. So as autonomy starts to make operations more efficient, that's going to decrease costs for the operator. If they're running a little bit more green, then that's going to decrease fuel costs, and that's effectively going to start to decrease costs for the consumer. So there you go, your Nikes are cheaper because autonomy has made that ship a more efficient operation. The next big steps are going to be just advancing the level of autonomy, making it so the system is more and more able to run without humans in the loop. Imagine an intersection with cars that doesn't have a stoplight and the cars can just go through at full speed. If the vessels know enough about each other, that's absolutely possible. The more you know about the environment, the more you can react to it and the more advanced behaviors that are possible. So it's going to be a major step for the industry.